I wanted to put a video out to pray for those that have recently crossed over and their loved ones that have been left behind here on Earth. My kitty is awake. But the souls that are transitioning or have transitioned, sometimes we don't understand how amazing the other side is. And I was graced many years ago to come close to feel that unconditional love of our Father, our Creator. And perhaps some of you have had that experience yourselves, a spiritual experience that was so profound that you didn't doubt the existence of God. So, first and foremost, I want to say a quick prayer, send healing energy to those who have lost that loved one, that those souls that are crossing over or have crossed over, we could continue to pray for those souls as they reunite with our Creator. So it's really, I wanted to this video to be more of a happier note, because I know that the information I give is pretty somber sometimes. It requires a little bit of work. I wanted to discuss what we feel, the emotions that people go through in the time of loved ones passing over. And I think I'm going to save that for another time, because I don't want to make this video too long. I just did some videos earlier, so I am inside doing this video because I have my kitty cat, which I'm so happy that I have. I got her back with me, and she is on her second night, and really missed me. I really missed her, and she is getting adjusted. So it's going to take a little bit because she is mainly an outside cat, inside, outside. But I'm hopefully going to transition her to an inside cat. She's over 10 years old, so we'll see how that goes. But I want to talk not necessarily on death, because I don't believe in true death. I believe that there is death of the physical body, and we have this spirit, we have our souls that will live on, and they do live on. There's plenty of movies, there's plenty of series, there's plenty of books out there that are fiction that touches on life after death, but there's also testimony of people that have had near-death experiences. And it's really a beautiful time. It's a transition for that soul. And it's really not anything to be feared. So this is a huge concept that a lot of people might not be comfortable with because they've lost loved ones, and the grief is real. I'm not saying that that's not real. It's very real. I've lost loved ones. I lost my father in 2019, and other relatives and other friends and family. So, and experience that the loss at a very early age. And maybe I'll go into that one day, but God wants me to talk about going within because it's a very accessible place for everyone. Some people think that they have to go into a meditation and or go into a group setting where everybody meditates, but I prefer to be alone. A lot of times when people are going through grief, they need that support from others. And however you grieve, however you want to celebrate your loved one's life or your friend's life or whoever passed over, however you want, that it's always a personal choice. I found that I'm more of when it initially happens, I like to go within. So, going within, there's so many answers you can find. Questions that you may have about any situation, any solution you could find within. Because when we go within, we are trying to connect with spirit, which in actuality, we're never disconnected with spirit. We're never disconnected with God. So the trouble is with some of us lies in the ability to discern the messages. Because sometimes we can mistake our own ego, our own voices, our own self-sabotaging mind. Our ego mind with the voice of God, the voice of our higher self, which is spirit. So, through meditations, through getting quiet, blocking out all the distractions of thoughts and responsibilities, that's really, where you can connect. And sometimes it happens spontaneously for some. You could be just getting up in the morning and being, you could be in that state of mind where you're open to communication from God. Because a lot of times when you just wake up, you don't have, work on the mind. You don't have, your mind is clear. So if anybody's experienced that, if you can, make that intention right before you really wake up, of course easier said than done, because usually when we wake up, we want to just pop up and, get to it and get our day started. So I'm going to leave it at that. This is a huge